What's up for this week? New soap base from Holy Cow, Sierra, with two kinds of milk and two kinds of whey. Hello again, Michael Friedrich here from beautiful North Carolina, and I have but one product for review today. But man, what a product. Holy cow, the name really applies. The Fougère Mania. This is the new soap base, which I think is called Sierra, I think. This is a very kind of a soft, creamy soap. And the reason it's so soft, a beautiful texture on the soap, you can see I have a kind of a very cool, light yellowish color, is that this is the soap base that includes two kinds of milk and two kinds of whey. So we just run through what's in here so you can get a feel for how super fatted this soap is. It is donkey milk and water buffalo milk, donkey milk whey and water buffalo milk whey. It also includes castor seed oil, shea butter, kokum butter, cocoa butter, linseed oil, tallow, and lanolin. So this is a very fatty, creamy soap. And we'll talk about that when we actually begin to build the lather. As I said, quite soft and a little bit sticky in texture. Oh man, the scent is fantastic off the puck. It is quite strong. It has a kind of an immediate strong neroli and lavender hit. So that first really bright note, it just really smells delicious. There is an undertone, which I get of, it's a kind of a bit of a woodsy green scent, which I think is oak moss. I think there's tonka in here. There's musk, maybe amber. But what I get is a big hit of the lavender and the neroli and a kind of an undertone, kind of a slightly woodsy, greenish undertone. Just a lovely, lovely scent. And as I said, quite strong. And I have to say, I do really like what they've done with the label. That's kind of a very cool, different look for these guys. Very, very well done on the label. All right, before I start lathering, let's go through the other products. It's going to be the Grey Dog Mixed Badger and Bar Knot in the Coca-Bola Rosewood handle. Lovely, lovely brush, huge knot. When this thing is dry, let me just sort of open it up. That's a big, big knot. I'm going to be using a Gillette, the Black Tip Super Speed. No blade in there yet. And I'm just going through sort of the individual blades I still have left today. Is going to be, I think it's the last one of these I have, which is a Battle Brothers double-edged blade, I believe. I have a small collection of individual or one or two blades of a certain type. So I'm kind of going through those, just working through those one at a time. Now, I did use a Gillette Silver Blue in this week, and that blade was just a bum. I didn't think the first day the shave was very, very rough. I thought, that really can't be. Second day, definitely was a case that blade was just bad. So, let me get my face wet. We'll start lathering up. We'll talk about the soap and the performance and rip through the shave. Yeah, can you believe it? Only one product for review today. Shabby. Not to worry. Future weeks may well have two, God only knows, maybe even three per week. Who knows? All right. I'm going to start off with a damp brush. Not really dry, not really wet. This works equally well with a dry brush loading or the wet brush loading, whichever way you want to go. Dry brush, you're going to likely pick up a lot of soap if you're lathering right out of the container, so just watch for that. It is a very thirsty soap. If you overload your brush, you're going to spend quite some time. I'm going to leave that relatively damp. I'm going to just wet the tips a little bit, because this brush just sucks up so much water. If you start with a wet or damp brush, you may get what you think is an unnecessarily frothy lather, but not to worry, it comes together beautifully. So either process you want to use is going to work great. What I've been doing is, if I start with the dry brush, immediately adding some water, just a few swirls, a bit more water, a few more swirls. It is the one downside to the method that I'm using to kind of protect the soap so I can pass these on. And as you know from those giveaways, I'm giving away quite a bit of soap, both on YouTube and on Reddit. Not ever lathering in the container means that you're always lathering from just a little bit of the soap. That can have an impact. Now this is already starting to form a very nice kind of pasty, creamy lather. I'm going to put just a bit more water in there. I'm going to wet my face. Drip some water on the brush. That already, look, you can see what's starting to happen here on the edge. Really nice. All right, wet face, put some water on the brush, and we'll build the lather. All right, just a little bit on there. Just make sure that the face of the brush is really kind of wet so you can see that. Yeah, I've been looking forward to using this after seeing some other reviewers post their impressions. I haven't watched any of the videos. I've just done some of the, read some of the write-ups. And this soap is 100% exactly up my alley because I really do prefer the milk-based soaps. They just work so well for my skin. They're so easy to lather. Post-shave generally is very good. Very good, and the sort of the creamy face feel is just what I prefer. And this soap is, well, let's cut right to the chase. Soap is just kind of amazing. It just feels so good on the face. It immediately feels creamy. Wonderful fatty feel to it. And in a texture, it actually feels kind of like a moisturizer. It has the same kind of creamy, fatty slickness to it. Nope, that is not wet enough. A bit more water. This soap does get very slick when wet, so don't stop when you think it looks good. You're gonna get a very glossy sheen to this when you have the water right. And you're gonna feel the brush move kind of effortlessly over the lather on your face. That's getting close. Yeah. That sounds wet and that looks wet. There we go. Looks like I may have lost a hair right there. There we go. Oh yeah, okay. Yeah, the soap is fatty, creamy, incredibly slick. I have, and what's gonna happen almost guaranteed today is the brush, when the lather drips down the handle of the brush, if it gets wetter at all, the bob of the brush is gonna get a little bit soapy and it's gonna 100% slide into the sink. It's happened almost every day this week. So here we go. Gillette Super Speed with the black tip. This is one of my favorite vintage razors. Very easy, mild shave. I've been going through basically a blade a day except for that one with the Gillette Blue. That was 2 days. Now the soap, oh, wow. Soap is just so slick. And residual slickness is excellent as well. Just yeah, kind of hard not to wax eloquent about it. Just really effortless movement of the razor over the skin. Yeah, and so now I'm rinsing my hand carefully in there because when you get soap on the handle, even though there is some knurling, it is very slick and slippery. There we go. So easy. You know, and you end up in this kind of arms race between soap makers, like who's gonna make the best of the best of the best? You keep thinking, well, how much better can it get? And how much better does it need to get? Yeah, residual slickness, by the way, when you rinse your face between passes, and I hope you are, Really, really nice. Okay. I've been lucky so far. Let me just rinse off my hand. No lather dripping yet. I'm just going to pull some of the stuff that's on the bottom there. You can take a good look. That sheen, that's what you're looking for. You don't need mountains of lather. You need a slick lather. Man, that just feels, I don't know, just feels amazing. So good. Yeah, the best soaps today are just so crazy good right now. Well, that's another hair. I think that's one of the boar hairs coming out. Now, I'm gonna add just a bit of water. I'm just kind of paint it in. Rinse my hands so the razor doesn't slip again. And now for the across the grain. Blade is just kind of skimming beautifully over the skin. Scent strength is still pretty strong and, in fact, pretty long-lived. So, even though, of course, you're rinsing your face well after the shave, you can definitely still smell it. I went Monday with just having used the soap to try to test the post-shave on its own, but also the scent strength, and very pleasantly surprised of how much I could still smell. I don't know what to say. It's fantastic soap. And despite being that fatty, not hard to lather at all. Razor is definitely still very comfortable shave. Less efficient than I remember, though. I've had to do a couple cleanup passes during the week, certainly under here where the hair is just that much denser and coarser. All right, third and final pass, unless I decide to do a quick touch up underneath my jawline, but we'll see. Let's just pull a bit of that lather out. Look how much is still in there. Great density to the lather. Wonderful creaminess. It kind of makes you wonder if you thought 5 years ago, like how much better can this really get? And then you would fast forward today. You take a look at where soaps are today in terms of the base, just the overall level of quality, the ingredients, kind of the richness of the soap, the amount of work that people are putting into the scents. What's going to happen in 5 years from now? All right, this is the Against the Grain. Look at my posh little finger. Posh, my friends. There we go. I'm being a bit quiet because I'm just really enjoying this. Wow. Mean, that slickness is just kind of absurd. All right, I should stop right there. Stop right there. No more. Rinse off. This is hard to rinse, quite fatty. Residual slickness is very, very good. You could easily do, although I don't recommend it, you could easily do another cleanup pass just like that. There is a lot of slickness left. Wow. That was an excellent, excellent shave. As mild as that razor is, I could definitely do another quick touch up if I wanted to get like super, super close, but I'm not gonna bother. Time to towel off. Make sure there's no embarrassing soap behind my ears. There we go. My post-shave. Post-shave is excellent. I mean, I think this is one thing where the soap really, really shines. Slickness is superior. Post-shave is really excellent. And that is in part because that soap is so fatty. And it really does feel in part like a kind of a dense face cream. It's not able to moisturize on its own, obviously, but it should leave your skin feeling pretty good. Now, what happens with me, this is true for every soap, immediate post-shave, very good. The next 3 to 5 minutes, my skin will feel a little bit dry. That's true for every soap, but it's the 10 or 15 minutes after that that really count. And for the one day that I didn't use any kind of post-shave, my skin felt actually really good. Very nice and supple, no kind of tightness, no dryness, no heat to it. It didn't feel like I used a post-shave balm, but the post-shave skin quality is still very, very good. And I think that that is 100% due to the milk and the whey. Milk-based soaps for me, just generally speaking, work better. They're really good for my skin. I hope you're having the same experience, and if so, fantastic. Now, what I am going to follow that up with today is going to be not a perfect match. I don't have the matching aftershave, and that's really okay. I'm going to go for the Barrister and Man. This is the Reserve Fern, which actually is a very, very good fit for that fougère scent. Let me just give this a very gentle shake. Beautiful scent. This is a little more well-rounded, I think, in the sense that the base notes come out a bit more for me. There's a bit of a bright hit up front, but that really very quickly settles down into what I feel is a slightly greener scent than the Fougère Mania. And see, this is the irony about the post-shave. You know, the shave soap itself offers certain post-shave qualities, of course. But then the first thing you do right after that is an alcohol and witch hazel-based aftershave, and that's going to have an impact. And while that may be skin soothing and maybe a bit of skin healing, it's not really skin moisturizing. So you're kind of counteracting the benefits of the soap a little bit, but I just really love that aftershave and the scent is a great mix. So that's what I'm gonna go for. Wow. That was an incredibly satisfying shave. Let's run through the products real quick. Another standout top-of-the-line shaving soap. I know we said in years past, how is this going to get any better? Well, this is an example of just how far people are pushing it. Excellent, excellent all-around soap. The scent is fantastic. The soap base is really very, very good. This may be the slickest soap that I've used so far. This is clearly in the top three for ones that I've used. The milk base and the addition of the whey. Oh! I forgot to mention, I think it also includes hops extract as well. Incredibly rich, incredibly creamy, beautiful dense lather, super slick, very good protection, wonderful post-shave qualities, excellent, excellent top-of-the-line product, and I think well worth the money that people are spending on it. Highly recommend it. Very, very good stuff. Let's do the aftershave second, so it doesn't always come in last. Barrister Man Reserve Fern, beautiful complement to that scent. Obviously, sort of works against a little bit this, sort of the skin moisturizing qualities, but actually, skin still feels very good, and I guarantee that'll be beautiful and smooth in just a little bit. Wonderful stuff. Love the scent. Nice pairing with that shave soap. The razor for today, this wonderful Black Tip Super Speed. Very mild, very comfortable shave. Not as efficient as I remember, but even doing a fourth pass, it's so easy and mild to use that really very, very risk of irritation or anything like that. Wonderful razor, and I think for this line, still my favorite vintage. Tech is way up there, but in terms of the super speeds, that one is 100% top of the line for me. And of course, this fantastic brush from Grey Dog. Thank you once again for the wonderful gift. This was one of three that he sent. I was expecting one, but he sent three, so that was fantastic. This is the mixed Badger and Bourne Knot, which I think came from Maggard's, and this beautiful Coco Bola Rosewood handle. This is an excellent knot, by the way. If you like kind of a mixture of a little bit of backbone and some density with just a touch of scritch, but you have the boar hair in there as well, which kind of helps with the splay and kind of the ease of use of the knot. And as you can see, not too much of a lather hog. Wonderful, wonderful mix. I think it's 70-30 for the mix. Well, we're gonna call it quits right there. I'm gonna walk away super happy from that shave, guys. As always, thank you again so much for watching. I really appreciate the time you're taking to watch these videos. As always, please feel free to leave questions or comments against this video or any previous video. Thank you again so much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.